नमस्कार. अलर्ट, ऍक्टिव्ह अँड अलाईव्ह ॲट 100 ह्या कार्यावळीत तुमचे स्वागत. डेम्पो हेल्थकेअर प्रस्तुत ही कार्यावळ आम्ही स्वर्गीय श्री विश्वासराव डेम्पो यांच्या यादीन राबवतात आणि दर शुक्रारा प्रुडंट मीडियाचेर रातचे 10 वरांचेर आम्ही तुमच्या बरोबर असतात. आरोग्याचे वेगवेगळे विषय तुमच्या समोर घेऊन त्याच्याबद्दल चर्चा करपाक, डिस्कशन करपाक आमच्या बरोबर असतात गोयचे नामनेचे हार्ट स्पेशलिस्ट डॉक्टर दिगंबर नाईक. वेलकम टू द शो डॉक्टर. नमस्कार.
नमस्कार.
डॉक्टर नाईक हॅज ऑलरेडी बीन रेकग्नाइज्ड ॲज वन ऑफ द 50 पाथ फाइंडर्स ऑफ द इंडियन हेल्थकेअर इंडस्ट्री अँड द बुक रिटन बाय हिम अलर्ट ॲक्टिव्ह अँड अलाईव्ह ॲट 100 ह्या पुस्तकान ताणी जे विषय मांडिले असा ताजी चर्चा करपाक आम्ही तुमच्या मुखार येतात. ह्या शोन आम्ही वेगवेगळे विषय हाताळतात पण त्या विषयाकडे वळच्या पहिली वेळ जाता तो आमच्याकडे पळोवप्यांकडून आयल्ल्या प्रश्नांची उतरां दिवपाक. बरेचशे आठवडे आमकां बरेचशे प्रश्न येतात पण देर इज वन कन्सिस्टंट क्वेश्चन दॅट हॅज बीन यू नो बीन आस्ड मेनी अ टायम्स अँड दॅट इज ऑफ हॅलिटोसिस. हॅलिटोसिस इज अ मेडिकल टर्म. इन कॉमन लँग्वेज वी कॉल इट बॅड ब्रेथ ऑर ऑफेन्सिव्ह ओडर ऑफ द माउथ. नाव द रिसेंट क्वेश्चन दॅट वॉज आस्क्ड was by a young man who says he cleans his mouth regularly but still he is not able to avoid bad breath. Now there are actually so many things that go you know behind having halitosis. Only oral and dental care may not be the only reason. So doctor, can you tell us what exactly are the causes of bad breath?
Okay. युजली पण सकाळ फडयले काय ना आम्ही युजली युअर माउथ इज फ्रेश बाय आफ्टरनून बाय इवनिंग यू फेस पीपल यू विल फाईंड मोस्ट ऑफ देम हॅव सम बॅड ओडर इन द माउथ. मोस्ट ऑफ देम स्पेशली एल्डरली दोज वर इन द 50s अँड 60s. ओके, यू विल फाईंड द देर इज अन ओडर इन द माउथ. And you see this evening discussions, they will try to stay away. The morning discussion, everybody is very good at hugging each other and being very close to each other. Okay, so this is what you really notice outside when this is happening. Okay, now mouth odor basically starts, let's look at the local problem,
right,
and systemic. Yes, right. There are diseases which create bad odor in the mouth,
right,
especially the kidney problems, diabetic problems. These people, we have lots of problems, few digestive problems, but these are the people which we have that odor because of the disease. We have to manage that disease well, but they have to be careful about this. Fatis have oral hygiene kashi dorab hejer almost 32 tips dadlele. In 32 days I was giving one or the other small tip saying how we take care of our teeth,
right?
Okay, and I think people are surprised to say that this is a detail we have to look at. When you eat, you know, all our teeth has got gap in between them,
right?
Okay, that is one part. And food, especially the chicken or the non-veg food, goes inside and gets stuck there. That is number one. Then you have the teeth. You have, most of us do not take a good care of our teeth. Quite a bit of us. Everybody doesn't go to a dentist today, while everyone has to go to a dentist.
Once in 6 months,
you must at least go for a checkup and you realize that there are so many problems. There are holes in the teeth, there are cavities, infections in the teeth, cavities in the teeth, and these are all sources of infection. If you take a drop of from them and put it under your microscope, you will find millions of bacteria inside.
And there is tartar build up.
Absolutely. Then there is a tartar, then there are gum and the gum diseases, then there are various ulcers in the mouth and on the tongue. Okay, they are necrotizing. They will all generate bacteria, and bacteria, as they start growing up, many of them generate different gases. Okay, many of them rot the food which is there. In 24 in 8 hours a chicken that we eat can will start rotting. The morning chicken can by evening it is rotting.
And
if you are not cleaning up your day properly during the early in the morning, you brush up your teeth whichever with a nice brush, the brush will not go in between these two teeth.
Right.
It will not go, it does not go, no brush will go inside. Mm-hmm. Because they are packed, you need to just go inside and your food particle is stuck there with force.
Mm.
So that is there, you need to get that food particle out.
Mm.
Okay. So the first thing that we have to look at for our oral hygiene is our oral hygiene.
Right.
A proper brushing of the teeth. More so before going to bed.
Right.
See, in the night, if we have food particles stuff there for 8 hours,
there for 8 hours,
it is going to be rotting there very
right.
nicely. Nothing else but rotting. You see, during the day, 8 hours, our tongue is not clean to that level.
Hmm.
But sakavde uttana thonan kitlo jeep kitli that asta.
Right.
So, ratik je rotting jata is much more than during the day. During the day, amcha saliva astabe. Saliva itself is a big antiseptic.
Hmm. Right.
Okay, so during the day, jiber kai ana pai. Sakai utle ki, you can take the smell from your mouth. You know it is an odor. Okay, so this is the commonest thing that we should see.
Hmm.
The first step I would give them is sancha kele, brush kele, and floss.
Flossing. Which most of them, miss
that,
doing it.
That little thread for me is more important than your brush. You can use your fingers for brushing, but use that floss in between.
Hmm.
That little thread, put it in between. Of course, it is nicely with the floss that you get, are better ones. Even if you don't get a floss, take a simple thread and do it.
Hmm.
Even if when you're flossing, even if little blood comes, it's still good. Much side incident the gamans and the illish blood, it you don't have to worry about that blood. The first thing is flossing and gargling at night and cleaning our tongue.
Cleaning the tongue.
So if we clean this up thoroughly and then go to sleep, the source of rotting is gone and the bacteria load has gone down.
Right.
So in the morning when you see your face is much, much smaller.
Sakafade
sagat on dutats. That is quite common. Still, if you don't do flossing in the morning, I won't mind. But night flossing
is
a must.
Important. I think these are the habits one has to
cultivate.
Like, you know, everybody has to tell their kids also. Children,
with kids, you give them potty habits, no? You have you really train them.
Yeah.
Your dog, you train them for a potty. We've got a nice words for it. You actually train them.
Yeah.
No, I'm training my child for a potty.
Hmm.
Okay. Nobody trains them for oral
hygiene. Is very important, and mostly kids are, you know, they get fed up of brushing.
Absolutely.
They are lazy. They just do a very small job and come out.
Okay.
So these are the things that we need to inculcate.
And people use if they have the odor, they go and scratch their teeth like anything. There's no point in scratching. I've seen teeth being denuded out by hard brush. The brush comes as soft, medium, and hard. Hard brush is not to be used by anybody because your teeth are not, gums are not that hard. It's soft and medium brushes to be used, and then one brush cannot be used for more than a week's time.
Right.
Because then the strength is gone, it just bends and it is just like a mop after that.
Right.
You need the brush to go into those small crevices and get those bacteria out and sterilize them. And the best sterilizer for mouth is water, not antiseptic, not our mouth goggles.
Right.
Mouth goggles are all spirit, alcohol and antiseptic. If you are continuously using mouth goggle day in and day out, it will destroy the normal bacterial flora of our mouth.
Right.
The mouth has got a normal protective flora. And on top of it, what we have to avoid is the additional flora that comes.
And this is a very important note for everyone, because now the mouth fresheners and mouth goggles are an in thing.
That is
everybody,
not a solution.
Yes, everybody thinks that by using the goggles, they have done the ultimate thing for the oral hygiene, which may not be. Now, this is a very
different harm.
And a very important
Once in a while, thing. It's okay. You have an infection, goggle at this for 7 days, 8 days, 10 days, that is fine. But if you are taking it every day, you see, the oral hygiene has got, your mouth has got its own flora. And on top of it, if that flora is there, it is difficult for a foreign flora to come. It's like your dog, you know. You have a dog, he decides, this is my boundary. He will never allow a second dog to come inside that boundary, isn't it?
Right.
Whether you have erected that boundary or no. If you decide this is my boundary, you will not allow a next dog to enter, come anywhere close to your house. Okay. Right. So also these bacteria do not allow the other pathogens. This is our normal flora, and those who come and destroy, we call them pathogen, the disease causing bacteria to come and grow there much. So the flossing is the must morning. If you brush nicely, floss it up and go in between these two teeth. See that the gums are okay. If your gum is not okay, you can just gently massage the gum. You don't have to use big gum gum tones and all those things. Just massage the gum with your fingers. Even if they bleed, let them bleed out. You'll find the next day your gums are much better. So this is, the hygiene is one part of it. The maximum, the commonest cause of halitosis is a poor hygiene. We don't realize. Morning we are washed. After every meal we should wash. Especially after lunch. We don't. And then we have a habit of eating sweets after this. After desserts. Sweets is a must, because this glucose and other sweets are very easily broken up here. Very easily digested right in your mouth. And they generate beautiful odors, which is enough to keep you.
Yeah, but there are some people who are in a habit of eating fennel seeds. Like, you know, body shape. Which so is also good.
Which is also good. Even body shape. The mouth freshness is another way. It is better to take these mouth fresheners than the antiseptic mouth fresheners. Because these itself, like your body shape asa, jeera asa, cardamom asa, fennel, these are all antioxidants. Even a little bit of it is going to give you, boost your whole immunity.
And lavang asa, clove is supposed to be the best in dental care.
Lavang is a painkiller.
And it is antibacterial also.
It is antibacterial as well as a beautiful, fantastic painkiller. Don't minta mito, your pain disappears. It is as good as you are putting lignocaine into your mouth, which is an anesthetic jelly. So this is for mouth. This is a beautiful, and that flavor of all these things is superb. So just clean, a simple cleaning with brush, with floss. That's it. And then massaging your gum with your soft brush or your finger, okay, and checking, going and checking your teeth at least once in 6 months. I would say all of us should go to a dentist and ask him to check our teeth at least once in 6 months, because we don't know what is happening to our inner teeth from inside. And if you find all, everybody has got good teeth in front, but our molars, they are all totally gone.
Because you can, you cannot reach there most of the time. You are not even aware.
You are not even aware. And you are aware. Till the time it starts giving you pain or a swelling. And that is too late.
So preventive measures are always
good.
We can, so we should visit your dentist.
We should all remain ourselves with our original teeth. And it is possible. Up to 100, it is possible. We don't have to get rid of our teeth. They could be as strong as ever. So this is one part.
And
of
what are the systemic things that you were mentioning about?
Absolutely. Before that, it's also what we eat.
There are some components like garlic, there is onion.
Garlic, onion, if you eat that, you know, you smell feet together. Especially when we go out, we should. Even some of the feet, if it's sane, I'm a fugon khatape. You eat that and go to see, you don't know, but your mouth is smelling. So these are the few things to be avoided. You have to be conscious about your mouth. See, no, who doesn't like a fresh breath? Your mouth should be actually smelling so fresh. That's number one. Besides, a fresh breath means healthy bacteria inside. You know, the diseases like heart attack, cancer are also a part, these are also a part of cause of such diseases.